to our dive objective. We're doing collections. Luis is doing photos. I'll do video. Max depth for us, we're doing max of 500 today. We'll be in the water at 10, so we can do a 5-hour dive. Priorities collections. Let's do it.
Cousteau is credited with this great quote, says that people protect what they love. And you can't love what you don't know.
The area that we visit, the official name for that particular depth range is mesophotic. So that's about 100 to 500 feet. It's beyond the reach of normal scuba diving.
Deep reefs or mesophotic coral reefs, they're not viewed as something that needs to be protected because people don't know what they are. With Hope for Reefs, we want to raise awareness and we want to show them why they need to be protected.
A lot of the times, because people think that those deeper reefs are safer, they're out of reach from human activities, they usually don't include them in protected areas. So if they create a marine protected area to protect coral reefs, they usually stop at the 100 feet depth line. The result for that is that there's a lot more fishing in some places in the deeper reefs than there is in the shallow reefs. My name is Luiz Rocha. I'm the curator of ichthyology at the California Academy of Sciences. I grew up in a coastal city in Brazil, always snorkeling, always going to the ocean. Today, one of the main things that are driving me is the desire that I have to save coral reefs. So Hope for Reefs is a large initiative being led by the California Academy of Sciences. One of the main objectives is to collect and identify like new or undescribed residents of the reef, in my case, fishes. So we find a fish that we haven't seen before, we try to take a good picture or collect it and then bring it back to the lab to basically identify and formally describe it. So mesophotic diving is, to me, very exciting because it's the next level of underwater exploration. The technical rebreather mixed gas diving is very dangerous. It's very complex. It requires a lot more gear than the standard scuba diving gear.
70% helium.
We usually descend through the normal coral reef and we can kind of see that change into this deeper, more mysterious, colder, darker mesophotic reef. The excitement of being at 400, 500 feet and seeing a fish that nobody has seen before is just beyond words to me. I mean, I love it.
Actually, this was the first fish I saw when we dropped down to the bottom. We saw a lot of these down there, and it's the first time they've been recorded from here, so that looks very cool.
So collecting these species very often contributes to policy change in meaningful ways. So when we go to a place, more often than not, we find a species that we knew it was there, but it doesn't have a name yet. And those are the known unknowns. And then the most exciting one is the one that we've never seen before, we see for the first time. It's the unknown unknown. Those, whenever we find them, it's like pure joy and excitement.
What did you get?
So a pipefish.
Very cold, but very good. Great dive.
We found one. We found one on this trip. We found an unknown unknown. So we took really nice photos. We collected one specimen. So the next steps here, so we'll take those back to the lab. We'll study their morphology. We'll describe them. Some of the things that our data can be used for example, would be to try to find better spots to create marine protected areas. Not all marine protected areas are equal. Some are created in places that don't really need protection. So one of the things that our data can really be well used for is to try to look at the places that better need protection right now.
It's one of the saddest things about all of this is that when I get to a place where nobody has dove before and I see a species that nobody has seen before, and it's super, super exciting, but invariably, 100% of the time, I'll see human trash, I'll see tumbled down corals, I'll see bleached corals. So we always see traces of human impact. We've been to places where the reefs were dying right in front of our eyes. One of the challenges we face is we try to do this fast enough before reefs actually die.